Hello everyone. So this work focuses on the study of the Langevin process embodied in a position domain and its application to quasi-stationary distributions. So this is a joint work with Tony Lelièvre and Julien Régnier. So the main motivation behind this work is to be able to build a better understanding of complex physical behaviors using molecular dynamics methods. However, these methods encounter metastability issues when we look at long timescale simulations, which means that particles remain trapped in regions of the phase space for very long times. Fortunately, there are accelerated molecular dynamics methods such as polar replica, which have been designed to tackle this issue using, for example, the objects known as quasi-stationary distributions. But the existence of such object is still an open question for molecular dynamics following the Langevin process, for example. And this is a question we answer here along with other QSD related properties. So for those of you interested in more details about this work, you can look at our preprint with Tony Lelièvre and Julien Régnier. So the setting is the following. We look at a bounded connected set, C2 bounded connected set of RD named O, and we study the Langevin process trapped in the domain D, which is O times RD. And this work is divided into two parts. The first one focuses on the study of the Langevin process trapped in D and the kinetic focal point equation to provide technical tools to be able to further our knowledge about QSDs and other properties. So let us take F, a smooth function from RD to RD, a real parameter gamma and sigma positive. The Langevin process is defined as the following. The first component is the position of the process, and the second is the velocity. So the time derivative of the position is the velocity, and the velocity follows a Austin-Uhlenbeck-like process. So we know that if gamma goes to infinity, the law of the position of the Langevin process goes to the law of the converges to the law of the overdamped Langevin process, which is defined here. And you can also obtain the infinitesimal generators of both processes. So our goal is to extend the knowledge of that we have on the overdamped Langevin process on smooth bounded domains to the Langevin process when we consider a bounded domain only in the position coordinates. So the main difference is that we consider here a focal Planck operator R, which is hypoelliptic and not elliptic, and the domain D is not bounded, only bounded in the first coordinates. So the first result is about the kinetic focal Planck equation. We're about to obtain a unique classical solution for the kinetic focal Planck equation with initial condition and boundary condition. And this solution admits a stochastic representation where tau here is the first exit time from D for the Langevin process. So if you partition the boundary of the domain D into three parts according to the direction of the velocity, you see that the boundary condition here applies only to a portion of the boundary, which is not the case for the elliptic case. And we have here a unique solution on a domain D, which is unbounded. So these are two main differences with the elliptic case. And we are also able to obtain an Harnack inequality, which extends a work from Gauss-Moore-Vasseur and using Harnack chains concept that you can find in this article. So then let us study the absorbed semigroup related to the Langevin process trapped in D. So again, tau here is the first exit time from D. So we can define this semigroup, and we obtain the existence of a smooth density function which satisfies the backward and the forward Kolmogorov equations. And we are able to obtain an explicit Gaussian upper bound of this transition density. So the Gaussian upper bound is the transition density of the following Gaussian process. And this is done inspiring ourselves from previous work on the parameter expected by Konakov, Mayelzi, and Mochanov in 2010. And this is interesting because we can show that this density Pt alpha is in L2 d times d, which means that using this equality, we can prove that Pt d is a is a Hilbert-Schmidt integral operator. Therefore, it's compact on L2D, and it allows us to apply to this semigroup well-known results like Prime-Lippmann theorem to obtain eigenvectors and eigenvalues to the semigroup. And you can also show that this semigroup is a compact on the Banach space of the continuous and bounding function on the domain D. So now we move on to the second part related to the QSD. So consider a process XT in a domain O. A QSD nu here is a probability measure such that if the process is initially distributed according to nu, and for a time t, it hasn't left the domain O until time t, then it's still distributed according to the probability measure nu. So if you have O, a C2 bounded connected set of RD, and you consider an elliptic diffusion process, for example, the overdamped Langevin process, then there has been a lot of work on the matter to prove that there exists a unique QSD nu on the domain O for example, overdamped Langevin process, and that this density satisfies three important properties. The first one is that it admits a density with respect to the Lebesgue measure on the domain O, that this density is the unique solution of an eigenvalue problem, where here you take the adjoint of the infinitesimal generator of the process YT, and you can prove a convergence results in total variation, which is exponential in time and with the speed and the prefactor here independent of the initial distribution. So here, this is the law of the process condition to remain in the domain, and this is the QSD. And the goal is using Krein-Lippmann theorem to be able to extend this work to the Langevin process. So we are able to do so and prove the existence of a unique QSD mu on the domain D, O times RD for the Langevin process XT. And it satisfies, again, these three properties. The first one, it admits a density with respect to the Lebesgue measure. And again, it's the unique solution to an eigenvalue problem we had adjoint of the Fokker operator. And you see here, again, the difference with the elliptic operator. We consider, for example, here only a portion of the boundary. And you can do the same for the Fokker operator. And here it's the boundaries, the exceeding velocities, and here the entering velocities. And we can obtain a speed, the same convergence, but the prefactor here is dependent on the initial distribution. And you see here that phi vanishes on gamma plus, and the prefactor here depends on phi. So you can choose an initial distribution that makes this prefactor goes to infinity. So there is an open question to know if we can obtain a prefactor here independent of the initial distribution theta. So now let us study the overdamped limit of the Langevin process. By overdamped limit, I mean when this coefficient gamma goes to infinity. So this is the Langevin process we consider. The only difference, so we choose gamma positive and make a slight difference. Sigma here is independent of gamma and multiply sigma by square root of gamma. And again, this is the overdamped Langevin process. So we have the following result. If F is globally Lipschitz, then it's easy to show, and it is shown in the Lievre-Rosset and Stolz, that the law of the Langevin, the position of the Langevin process evaluated at gamma t on this bounding interval converges weakly to the law of the overdamped Langevin process when gamma goes to infinity. And to study the overdamped limit, when gamma goes to infinity to the QSD of the Langevin process, we extend this result to the following. We couple this process with the velocity at the last time here, evaluated at gamma t, and we're able to prove that it converges to this law, where z is a Gaussian vector with centered and with following variance, and is independent. This is really important for the proof, is independent of the overdamped Langevin process. And you're able to deduce from this theorem the overdamped limit of the Langevin QSD, which is given here. So this is the Langevin QSD on the domain D, which is O times RD, and it converges weakly to the following density. So here it is the density on O of the overdamped Langevin QSD. And here it's the density of the previous Gaussian vector. So So as a matter of conclusion, I will quote, I will give some references on similar works on QSD. So Champagny and Villemomé have worked on conditions for the existence and uniqueness and convergence of results for QSD for general Markov processes. And working with them, we were able to deduce similar results for existence, uniqueness, and convergence property for the QSD for the Langevin process. And this is a work we are going to submit soon. I also worked with Etienne Bernard on the subject to find alternative ways to prove these results. And so now that we have a quasi-stationary distribution for the Langevin process, we know that parallel replica, like other accelerated molecular dynamics, are efficiently working when we consider a Langevin dynamics, which was not the case until now. And here are the references of all the works I mentioned in this presentation. And you will find in our preprint more details on the proofs and related work. So thank you for your attention.